Hannah Szenes, was born on July 17, 1921, to an assimilated Jewish family in Hungary. Her father, Béla, a journalist and playwright, died when Hannah was 6 years old. She continued to live with her mother, Kathrine, and her brother, György. She enrolled in a Protestant private school for girls that also accepted Catholic and Jewish pupils. However, those of the Catholic and Jewish faith had to pay double and three times the amount Protestants paid. After her mother thought it was too expensive, Szenes was declared a gifted student and allowed to only pay double the usual amount. This, along with the realization that the situation of the Jews in Hungary was becoming precarious, prompted Szenes to embrace Zionism, and she joined Maccabiah, a Hungarian Zionist students' organization. In 1943, Jewish agency officials made overtures towards Szenes to join a clandestine military project whose ultimate purpose was to offer aid to beleaguered European Jewry. The young immigrant, who became a member of the Palma, first studied in a course for wireless operators, and in January 1944 participated in a course for paratroopers. Before leaving Palestine, she met with her brother Jura, who had just arrived from Europe, the sole surviving member of her immediate family other than her mother. And the two spent the afternoon together on the shores of the Mediterranean, bringing each other up to date with personal and family news. Hannah Szenes was a poet and a special operations executive member. In mid-March 1944, she and several other Palestinian Jewish volunteers were dropped into Yugoslavia in order to aid the anti-Nazi forces until they would be able to commence their true mission and enter Hungary. The German invasion of Hungary in March 1944 postponed their plans, and Szenes crossed the border to her former motherland only in June of that year. Captured within hours of having stepped onto Hungarian soil, she was sent to prison in Budapest, where she was tortured by Hungarian authorities in the hope of receiving information regarding Allied wireless codes. Within days of entering Hungary, her two co-parachutists were also captured, unaware of Szenes' whereabouts. Only one of them, Jól Pálgyi, was to survive the war. She was one of 37 Jewish SOE recruits from Mandate Palestine parachuted by the British into Yugoslavia during the Second World War to assist anti-Nazi forces and ultimately in the rescue of Hungarian Jews about to be deported to the German death camp at Auschwitz. Szenes was arrested at the Hungarian border, then imprisoned and tortured, but refused to reveal details of her mission. When the Hungarian authorities realized that Szenes would not be broken, they arrested her mother, and the two women came face to face with each other for the first time in almost 5 years. Kathrine Szenes had no idea that her daughter had left Palestine, not to speak of the fact that she was now in Hungary. Initially shocked as they brought in the young woman with bruised eyes and who had lost a front tooth in the torture process, she rapidly regained her composure. And both mother and daughter refused to give the authorities the performance that would lead to the information they had sought. For 3 months the two women were near yet far, sharing the same prison walls, but unable to catch more than short glimpses of each other. In September 1944, after Kathrine Szenes was suddenly released, she spent most of her waking hours seeking legal assistance for her daughter, who, being a Hungarian national, was to be tried as a spy. In November 1944, Hannah Szenes came up before a tribunal and eloquently pleaded her own cause, warning the judges that as the end of the war was nearing, that their own fate would soon hang in the balance. Convicted as a spy, Szenes was sentenced to death, although the court had decided not to carry out the sentence with alacrity. However, her poignant speech during the trial was taken as a personal affront by the officer in charge, Colonel Simon, who came into her cell on the morning of November 7, 1944, and presented her with two options: to beg for a pardon, or to face death by a firing squad. Hannah Szenes was executed on 7 November 1944, Budapest, Hungary. Refusing to beg clemency from her captors, whom she did not consider legally permitted to try her case, Szenes penned short notes to her mother and her comrades and went to her death at age 23, in a snow-covered Budapest courtyard, refusing a blindfold in order to face her murderers in the moments before her death. Her body was buried by unknown persons in the Jewish graveyard at Budapest. Kathrine Szenes, who escaped from the infamous Budapest Death March, hid in that city until its liberation by the Soviet forces in January 1945. Having immigrated to Palestine, where she joined her surviving child, Jora, she became an instrumental part of the Hannah Szenes legend, based on her daughter's courageous life and death. Brought to public knowledge by 15 editions of her daughter's diary, poetry, and plays, that have since been published in Hebrew. In 1950, Hannah Szenes's remains were brought to Israel, where they were buried in the parachutist section in the military cemetery on Mount Herzl in Jerusalem. In the same year, a kibbutz was founded and called Yad Hannah in her memory. She is regarded as a national legend in Israel, where her poetry is widely known and the headquarters of the Zionist youth movement's Israel Hatzera. A kibbutz and several streets are named after her. Today's shout-out goes to Ann Jones. Thank you, Ann, for your support. Thank you for watching Death Row.